Subject code CS152, Introduction to Computer and Programming. Here, today we will discuss about the organization of the computer, basic concept of computer organization, CPU, memory, RAM, ROM, EPROM, binary numbers, binary arithmetics, binary floating point numbers, and binary arithmetics. Here, in this class, we will discuss about this. So, first we will discuss what is the means of computer. What is computer? What is the need of the computer? Why we use computer? Yes, here we know that. Here we use the computer for the calculations, arithmetic and logical calculations, and we know that the factor is we want to complete the calculation with the speed and accuracy. So now we also know that a computer can store a large amount of data. Here it accepts data and raw data and process it and generate the meaningful information. So here now we can combine all these concepts and now we can write the definitions. First, see, we know that we use the computer for the arithmetic and logical calculations. Here now we can define a computer is an electronic device which perform arithmetic and logical calculations with speed and accuracy. It can store a large amount of data, and a computer system process the raw data and generate some meaningful information with speed and accuracy. So in this way we can define the computer. Here, see, this is the block diagram of the computer. Generally, we see an input unit, second is the processing unit, and third is the output unit. Here, this is the input unit, this is the CPU, it is the combination of control unit and ALU. Here CU means control unit, ALU means arithmetic and logic unit. This is the main memory, secondary storage, and the output device. When we type any information, first the information is stored in the main memory. So that is the RAM. Here this control unit, it supervises or it control whole the unit. So here this control unit, it is connected to every unit of the CPU. Here it is connected to every unit. Here when we type anything, any information that is stored in the main memory, then the control unit decide which type of operations we want to perform, and according to that it controls the units. So here now the definition of the computer we can define in this way: a computer can process data, picture, sounds, graphics. They can solve highly complicated problems quickly and accurately. What is the need of the computer? It accepts data or instructions. It store large amount of data. It can process data as required by the user. It gives the result in the form of output. It controls all the operations inside a computer. Then what is the input unit? What is the means of the input unit? This is the process. This is the process of entering data and program into the computer system. By using that device, we can input the data to the computer. And a device that is used to enter data and instruction into the computer, data that can read from the input device is stored in the computer memory. Here we know that there are some popular input devices like keyboard, mouse, etc. Then what is ALU? ALU means arithmetic and logic unit. The actual processing of data and instructions are performed by the arithmetic and logic unit. It performs arithmetic and logical calculations. Arithmetic calculation means addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, comparisons, like this. And logical calculations, AND operations, or not. So these are the logical, logical operations. Then numerical data in the form of integers are supported by all the computers. Some computer also support floating point numbers. Logical operations include the boolean functions like yes, such as and or not operations. Then what is the means of this control unit? Control unit is responsible for coordinating various operations using time signals. The control unit determines the sequence in which computer program and instructions are executed. The control unit coordinates the activity of the various components of the computer. The ALU and the control unit together comprise the CPU. CPU means central processing unit. The CPU is also called the brain of the computer and also known as microprocessor. The speed of a computer depends on the clock frequency of the microprocessor. In addition to the main processor, there are coprocessors to speed up the operation of the main processor. Here we know that the whole units are connected with this control unit. So we can say the control unit supervise all the units. And it also performs the activity like memory management, input-output management, etc. Then the memory. Here there are two types of memory. One is the main memory and another is the secondary storage. First, see what is memory. Memory means in the memory we use the registers, internal cache, external cache, main memory, and the secondary memory. This is the hierarchy of the memory. Here, this is the register. Your registers are the locations within the microprocessors where data is stored temporarily during the processing. These internal high-speed registers are used in arithmetic and logical operations to holding the data operands. Internal cache is the smallest high-speed memory. Is the internal high-speed memory that contains the frequently used data. The use of cache memory avoid repeated reading of data from the slower main memory. External cache. When the internal memory are not present, then we use the external cache that is placed between the CPU and the main memory. Next is the main memory. Main memory is also known as RAM. RAM means random access memory. This is the volatile memory. Volatile memory means when we switch off the power supply, when the power supply is switched off, the contents of this memory will be lost. So here the main memory is also called RAM. Microprocessor instructions can directly access main memory locations. Main memory is fast but expensive. It is a volatile. The contents stored will be lost when the power supply is cut off. Next is the secondary storage. Secondary storage, when we want to store the data permanently, then we use the secondary storage. Here, this is the non-volatile memory. So here, the secondary storage, all the data and programs required by the computer cannot be stored in the main memory because it is small and the volatile in nature. Secondary memory is needed to store the data and instruction permanently and these are not currently required by the microprocessors. Secondary memory is slower but less expensive as compared to the main memory. It is non-volatile and large in size. The microprocessor cannot access the secondary memory directly. Therefore, data from this has to be brought in the main memory so that the processor can use it. So here, first, this is the CPU. It cannot access the secondary memory directly. First, it sent the request, so the data and the instructions in the secondary storage are first loaded into the main memory. Then the control unit or the CPU it uses the data for the processing. Output unit. This is the output unit. What is the means of this output unit? When we have the process data, then the process data or the results that are displayed on the output unit. If we want to display the information, then we can display on the monitors. And if we want the print, then the output should print on the printer. So here, the monitor and the printer are the output device. Here the register is the fastest memory and the secondary memory is the slowest memory in compared to all. So this is the hierarchy of the memory. Then the secondary memory, then we can also classify the secondary storage then one is sequential access device and the direct access device. Here the example of this device is tape, magnetic tape. This is the magnetic tape. Here again we can classify in in the three category. One is the magnetic device, magnetic disc. This is the optical disc, and third is the memory storage disc. Here the example of the magnetic disc is the floppy disk and the hard disk. Optical disk, here we can classify in this category. One is the CD-ROM, then CD-R, CD-RW, and the DVD. Magnetic storage device that is also classified in these two categories. One is the flash drive, and another is the memory card. In this way, we can classify the secondary storage. Next is the number system. There are four types of number system. One is decimal, two octal, third binary, and fourth is hexadecimal. In the daily routines, generally we use the number system, decimal number systems. So a number system assign meaning of the position of the numeric symbols. For example, here suppose we have this 450. It means here we are using a set of symbols. So it depends upon the numbering we are using. For example, now suppose we have 357, so that is 300 plus 50 plus 7. So here this is in the base of 10. So this is in the base of 10. So this number is called the decimal numbers. So what is the means of this base? The base of a number determines the number of digits or symbol that the value of digit positions. Here, the base of the decimal number is 10. It means we have 10 symbols, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Here, the octal number has the base 8. It means 8 symbols, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Binary number, base 2, 2 digits, 0 and 1. Hexadecimal, base is 16. So there are 16 symbols, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then A, B, C, D, are the four types of numbers, and this is the base of these number systems. Now we will see the conversion of number systems. Here, first see decimal to binary. Means we have a decimal number, now we want to convert its equivalent binary numbers. So we know that the base of the decimal number is 10 and the base of binary number is 2. So now see the example, how can we convert this? Now suppose we have a number 25, base is 10, now we want to convert this number in binary. The procedure is very simple. Divide this number by this base, 2. Here 2 means 12 and the remainder is 1. Next 2, 6, 0, 2, 3, 0, then 2, 1, 1. So here, what is the equivalent of this? This is equivalent to this binary number. So that is 11001. In this way, if we have any decimal number, then we can convert to its equivalent binary number. See the reverse case. Now suppose we have 37 in base 10. Now we want to convert to its equivalent binary number, then we can divide this 37 by 2. Next, decimal to octal. Now suppose we have a number 574 in decimal. Now we want to convert this number in octal. So what is the procedure? Procedure is same. Here in the when we have the decimal number, then we divide by 2. Now in this case we have the decimal number, here the base is 8, now divide this number by 8, 8574, here this is the 71, and the remainder is 6. Then divide this 8 64, then yeah, this is the 7, then 8 1, and the remainder is 0. Now write from bottom to top, so that is 1076. This is the equivalent octal number. Now suppose if we want to convert this number decimal to hexadecimal. We have the decimal number, now we want to convert this number in hexadecimal. We know that the same problem 170, 574, this is 10, or and we can take 268, that is 10. Now we want to convert in hex. Here the base of the hexadecimal is 16, so we will divide this number by the 16. 16, 268. This is the 16, and the remainder is 12. Then the 16, 10. Then right from bottom to top 10. We know that here in the hexadecimal A is 10, B is 11, C is 12. So here this is 12, so we will write C. So that is 10C. So this procedure is very simple. See here, if we have a decimal number, then we can convert to any number of system by dividing the base. This clear? Then the next is the reverse base. Now suppose if we have the binary number, then how can we convert binary to decimal? See, if we have the binary number 11001, base is 2. Now we want to convert this number in decimal. Then what is the procedure? 11001, 1 from this right to left, 1 into 2 key power 0 plus 0 into 2 key power 1 plus 0 into 2 key power 2 plus 1 into 2 key power 3 plus 1 into 2 key power 4. Now you can solve this. So this is 1 into 1 plus 0 plus 0 plus 8 plus 16. So that is equal to 25. Next, now suppose we have 1076 in octal. Now we want to convert this in decimal. Then the procedure is simple. 1076, here the base is 8, here the base is 2, here the base is 8. So the procedure is same. First step, this digit 6 into 8 key power 0 plus 7 into 8 key power 1 plus 0 into 8 key power 2 plus 1 into 8 key power 3. So that is equal to 6 into 1 plus 56 plus 0 plus 64 into 8. Then now you can solve it, and the value is 574. So this is this is 512. The 512, 56 and 6. Next, now suppose we have a number in hexadecimal 10C. Now we want to convert this in decimal. Then what is the procedure? The procedure is also the same. 10C, that is equal to C into 16 की पावर 0 plus 0 into 16 की पावर 1 plus 1 into 16 की पावर 2. So this is 12 multiply by 1, so that is 12 plus 0 plus 256. So that is 268. So this is the second method. This is the second conversion. If we have any number system, then we can convert to its decimal. In the previous, we convert that any number in decimal. We convert the decimal number to any number system. Here, if we have any number system, then we can convert to its equivalent decimal. Now suppose we want to convert a number octal to binary, then what is the way? Now suppose we have 1076 base 8. Now we want to convert it hexadecimal. Then what is the procedure? First, we convert the number in the decimal, then we convert to its equivalent hexadecimal. We also have a method C. The base of octal number is 8, the base of binary number is 2. Here, every one octal digit, that is equal to three equal binary digits like this: 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 0, 3, 0, 1, 1, 4, 1, 0, 0, 5, 1, 0, 1, 6, 1, 1, 0, 7, 1, 1, 1. Like this, hexadecimal. Here, 0, that is equal to 4 binary digits: 1 0 0 0 1 2, 0 0 1 0, 3 0 0 1 1 4, 0 1 0 0 5, 0 1 0 1 6, 0 1 1 0 7, 0 1 1 1 8, 1 0 0 0 9, 1 0 0 1 10, 1 0 1 0 11, 1 0 1 1 12, 1 1 0 0 13, 1 1 0 1 14, 1 1 1 0 and 15, 1 1 1 1. Here this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, this is E, and this is F. So these are the symbols in the hexadecimal. Now see, we can convert. Now suppose if we have a number in octal 10 76. This number is in octal. Now we want to convert this number in hex. We have two procedure. One, convert this octal to decimal, then decimal to hexadecimal. Or you can convert this octal number to binary and then binary to the hexadecimal. See, 1076, you can write the 3-digit code for every digit. 1 0 0 1 0 7 and 6. So this is the binary equivalent of this. So this is the binary equivalent of this octal number. Now you can make the group of fours like this. 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 1 0. Make the group of four like this. This is 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0, that is 2. This 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 1, that is 3. 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0, that is E. So the equivalent 1076 is 23 E. Next, now suppose we have 10C in hex. Now we want to convert this number in octal. Then what is the procedure? First, write the 4-digit code of this one, 001C, base this. First, convert this number in binary. Binary means, for this one, 00010C, C means 1100. Then now this is the binary equivalent. Now we can convert make a group of 3 3. This is 0, this is 1 0 0, so that is 4 1, this is 4. So 414 in octal. In this way, if we have any number system, then we can convert to its equivalent any number system. Next, next is binary arithmetic. Binary arithmetic. First, see the addition. Zero plus zero, that is 0, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, 1, 1 plus 1, that is 1, 0. Here, this carry will add it to the next digit. For example, now suppose we want to add 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1 1 1 1 1 1. Now suppose we want the addition, then we can add 1 plus 1, this is 0, that is 1. Here 1 1 1, so that is 1, and 1 is the carry. Again this 1, 1 is the carry. Then this 1, again this 1 is the carry. 1, this 1, 1 plus 1, 1 0. So the result is 1 0 1 1 1 0. Next is the subtraction. This is the subtraction. Next is the subtraction. In the subtraction, 0 minus 0, that is 0. 1 minus 0, that is 1. Then 1 minus 1, that is 0. Then 1 0 minus 1, that is 1. Here this is the 0. 0 minus 1, you can't subtract 1 from the 0, so you require a borrow. So this is the borrow. Now this is 1 0, 1 0 minus 1, so that is 1. Now see the subtraction. 1 1 0 0 1. 1 0 0 0 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 0 minus 0, 0 minus 0, 1 minus 0, 1. And this is 0. So this is the result. Now suppose 1 0 1 0. Now we want to subtract 0 1 1 1. See, from this 0 and this 1, you can't subtract 1 from this 0. You require a borrow. Here this is the 1, 1 0 minus 1, so that is the 1. Here this is 0. Now you can't subtract this 1 from this. You require a borrow, so take the borrow here. Now this is the 1 0, 1 0 minus this 1. Now this is 1 0, 1 0 minus this 1, so that is the 1. Here this is the 0, here this is the 1, 1 minus 1, so that is the 0. Here this is the 0, 0 minus 0, so that is the 0. So this is the 0. Next is the next is the multiplication. This multiplication is also the same as 1 1 0 1 1 1 0, then multiply by 1 0 0 0 1. The procedure is same as in the decimal. First multiply this 1 by this digit 1 1 1 0 0. Now the shifting 0 0 0 0 0. Again the next shifting 0 0 0 0 and this 0. Again 0 0 0 0 0. Next this 1, this multiply by this 1, 0 0 1 1 and 1. This is the 0, this 0, this 1, this 1, this 1, this 0. Yeah, this is the 1 1 1 0 1. We have this digit, so this is 1. Here this is 1. So this 1, 0, 1, 1, this is 1 plus 1, that is 0, and this is the 1. So this 1, 1, 1 and 1. Next is the division. Division is also the same. Divide 1 1 0 1 1 0 by 1 0 1. The procedure is same. 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 0. So first 1 1 0 1, then the subtract with this 0, so that is the 1. Then next digit is 1, but we can't divide this, so we again require this 1. Then 1 0 1, so that is the 1. again the subtraction. So next is the 1 minus 1, 0, this is 1. Then we can't divide, this is 0, so we can't divide this. So 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, and this is the remainder. So this is the quotient and this is the remainder. The procedure is the same as in the decimal. Now suppose if we have a number like this, express the number 0.6876 in the binary equivalent. This is the number in the decimal. Now we want to convert this number to its binary equivalent. So fraction multiply by the base, next remainder, new fraction and the integer. Here the number is 0.6876. This is multiplied by the base of the binary number. So that is 1.375. New fraction, now this number 0.375 and the integer is 1. So that is the MSB. Here, top to bottom. Next is 0.375. This 0.375 multiplied by 2, so that is 0.75. Next, the remainder is 0.75 and this is 0. Next, 0.75 multiplied by 2, that is 1.5. Here, this is 0.5, so that is 1. Next is 0.5 multiplied by this 1.0, this is 0.0, this is 1. Here 0.6875, base is 2, base is 10, that is equivalent to 0.1011, base is 2. See the reverse case. 0.1011, if we want to convert this number in binary, in decimal, then what is the procedure? See, from this left to right, after the decimal, 1 into 2 key power minus 1 plus 0 into 2 key power minus 2 plus 1 into 2 key power minus 3 plus 1 into 2 key power minus 4. So that is 1 divided by 2, 0, 1 divided by 8 plus 1 divided by 16. So that is equal to 0.6875. So this is the completion of first chapter. So that is the introduction to computer and the number system.